Good morning. Welcome back to Outlook Portland. We're talking about Oregon's upcoming sesquicentennial in the year 2009. But really what we're talking about is a big year-long party. I've got the right person to talk about parties with. It's Penny Trumbull, who's the marketing director for Oregon 150. And really what you're describing, though, is a really genuine sort of series of events. This is not, you know, unveiling a plaque on a wall or having a statue. This is about a very personal type of thing and a very community-oriented. And one of the most interesting aspects so far is this Oregon Story Project that you've got going.
Oh, it's magnificent, really.
And you're asking people to participate on a very personal basis.
A very personal level. And I think every single person has a story. And so we're asking you to put down in writing your Oregon story.
And it's kind of about your relationship with Oregon.
It can be about anything you want it to be. It could be about your family. It could be about a moment that you've had when you realized how much you love Oregon. It could be about a vacation you've taken. It could be about when you summited Mount Hood. It could be about anything that you'd like it to be.
I think this, you know, and this Oregon's one of the places, rare place where you can do this, where you can say to people, tell me your Oregon story. And as I was saying earlier, you know, if you said, tell me your New Jersey story, even people who live in New Jersey would say, well, what are you talking about? You know, I pulled off at exit 35 once and I got gas, and that's my New Jersey story. But Oregon story has this emotional kind of component about choosing to be here, choosing to live here. And one of the ones is from the governor of the state, and Governor Kulongoski, who writes, I think very movingly, he came here from Missouri and chose to be here, got out of the Marine Corps. And his story is not at all political. It's about hiking and thunderstorms.
And his wonderful wife, Mary Oberst.
What are some of the other examples of stories?
David, there's so many, and you really need to go to our website to see them. But there's just the most compelling stories by people that, you know, third and fourth generation Oregonians, people that have traveled and had chosen Oregon. People really choose to live here.
I think those are some of the interesting stories on your website. Or some of them are those multi-generational ones where they have farmland and they're in a small community and what that inheritance means to them, which is very, very moving. And then there are the stories of the people who say, you know, I came here and I remember stepping off the train in 1943 and I felt hopeful again, that sort of thing.
Or 2009.
Well, what's your, 2009. What's your Oregon story? Are you going to share that yet?
How much time do we have?
I know, you never kiss and tell. You just never kiss and tell. We'll try to get you to do that a little bit later. But, you know, another part of the story has also been set to music, which is also,
yes.
I mean, that I'm not surprised that music comes into it, given your own background. But this is a revival of a song that was originally written during the centennial in 1959.
It was a radio
show. A radio
show. Oregon, Oregon by Stan Freberg. And maybe some people out there remember Stan Freberg. He's 84 now. He's alive and well.
He's one of the great television musical producers of the 1950s, early television.
Yes, and it was a silly, silly, silly thing. And Thomas Lauderdale, our own Thomas Lauderdale from Pink Martini, met with Stan and decided to see if he could bring this back to life. And fortunately, he has. And he's going to be writing a new prologue and a new fourth act. And they're bringing it back together with the Pink Martini group. And they're going to be performing it in 2009. It's going to be amazing.
And originally, in 1959, the Blitz Weinhard Brewery, great local business at the time, commissioned this.
Yes.
And the lyrics from 1959, very reflective of that time, and lumber mills and, you know, fishing and all the things that would equate not only with now, but also with that time. And so this 84-year-old gentleman is now updating that for today's Oregon.
Yes.
And when's that going to be unveiled?
And that's going to be in the summer of 2009. And that will be also sponsored by the Wessinger family and also the Kinsman Foundation have been kind enough to really help us with their support of that project. It's going to be fun.
I think
this is
kind of the fun thing about this is that it does reach into the past and it does connect us very clearly with our traditions, but then it kind of modernizes it and then sets us looking forward as well, all at the same time.
It really does, and it all comes around.
So the song will be revealed at the state fair, and then it's going to be performed again around the state.
Yes, it'll be performed in Bend and also in Bend.
Dofer Threshing Bee, Elgin Roundup.
And at the Washington Park Amphitheater.
Great. Well, that's going to be a lot of fun. And I want to talk some more about these great events to come up.
Great.
Right now, we've got to take a break, but we'll be right back with Penny Trumbull and talk some more about Oregon Sesquicentennial here on Outlook Portland.
Outlook Portland will continue in a moment.